Now we are going to mathematical structure of quantum mechanics, and in this chapter, first I will give you a generalization of vectors to give you some basic knowledge of linear algebra. But I still recommend you to watch the video, the series of videos which is called Essence of Linear Algebra by 3.1 in YouTube to get some basic on linear algebra. And after this mathematical basics part, I will tell you something about Dirac notation, which contains graphs and tags. These are some kind of symbol we have already used once to represent states and some representation of states. And along with this, I will introduce you some observables and operators and the commutator of operators. And after this, I will talk about the question about evolution along with time. And so our first step is to give you a generalization of vectors. In high school, you might have been learned something about vector. Like vector is an arrow with a specific length and a specific direction. And you may also define vector as two numbers in a bracket. And you might put vectors in a Cartesian coordinate, and the end of the vector is represented by this combination of numbers, and the start point of the vector is 0, 0 point. So you now have two kind of picture of vector. One is in a more visible and direct way, and another one is in a more algebraic way. I want to make some generalization about vectors. First, this is a two-dimensional vector. And in high school, you might have already know some kind of three-dimensional vectors. We can have three perpendicular axes, and we can have an arrow in the three-dimensional space, and using a three-dimensional combination of numbers to represent vectors. The first thing I want to say is that vectors can be more than three-dimensional. Maybe they don't have a visible picture, but it can be in this is an n-dimensional vector. And what I want to say more is that vectors can also be written in a different direction. You can also write a vector in this way. This is a kind of vector, this is another kind of vector. In high school, we always put real number inside the vector. But we can, in a more generalized way, we can also put complex number in vectors. Complex number, I have mentioned before. Is a more generalized number system. It's the first complex number you will find is I. I is the abbreviation of imaginary number. And imaginary number, in an imaginary counterpart of real number, and I equals to the square root of negative 1, and this number does not exist in real number. However, we set a new kind of number for it, which is called imaginary number. And a real number a plus I makes the whole, if the a gone through all the real number, and this product gone through all the imaginary number. If we add b to it, and if b gone through all the real number, and a plus I gone through all the imaginary number, we get all the complex number. So we can also put complex number in a plane. This axis is real number, and this axis is imaginary number. And a point, like this is A, this is B, this is representing the complex number A plus BI. Both A and B are real number, but BI is an imaginary number, and A plus BI is a complex number. And this is the definition of complex number. And we're always using the letter C to represent complex number. The vector can be the combination of numbers, of real numbers, and it can also be the combination of complex numbers, and we call it complex vector, like this. This is a complex vector, and this is an n-dimensional complex vector. And what I want to say more is the dimension of vectors cannot only be more than 3, but can also be infinite. We can put n to infinite. We can get an infinite number of vectors. And we can get this kind of infinite number of dimensions of vectors, but we can also get a continuous infinite dimensions of vectors, like this. Now we get an x, y, z, three dimensional space, and in this space we have a lot of vectors, and every vector is able to be represented by a three number combination. We can also put these three axes in a parallel way. This is x, y, z. And if we set a point on each axis, we have determined a three-dimensional vector. And if we add more axes and set a point on the new axis, we got a four. We set a new point in the new axis. We got a new four-dimensional vector, and we can add the axes continuously. We can add a lot of axes and made it a plane. These are all axes, and we chose a point at each axis. And if we put this point, if we set all the points in the axis, what do we get? We get a function. So if we have a function defined on 0 to 1, if we have a function defined on 0 to 1. It can also be perceived as an vector. A vector with continuous infinite dimensions. So all the functions that define on 0 to 1 form a space, a continuous infinite dimensional space. If we put 0 to 1 to negative infinite and positive infinite, we got a function defined on real numbers, on all the real numbers, we also get a continuous infinite vector. It can also be perceived as a continuous infinite dimensional vector. And all these vectors form a space. And if this function itself is not real number, but complex number, it can also be a continuous, infinite, dimensional, complex vector. And all this kind of vector form a new vector space, complex vector space. And this vector space is called Hilbert space. So we can consider Hilbert space as a vector space, and we can also consider Hilbert space as a set of all the complex functions that define on real numbers. So this is Hilbert space, and now I have